Whether it's to fuel your late night study session or trying to stay alert on the job, energy drinks are very popular, with 76% of young adults consuming them. But what would happen if you only drank energy drinks? One sip and the feel-good effect is almost immediate. When the sugar molecules hit your taste buds, it triggers your brain to release dopamine, the hormone responsible for feelings of happiness and well-being. This makes sense considering the sugar content of one can ranges from 2 teaspoons to a whopping 14 teaspoons per serving, depending on the brand. Within 10 minutes, both your heart rate and blood pressure increase in response to adrenaline release caused by the introduction of caffeine into your body. How much caffeine? As high as 242 milligrams per serving. To compare, a serving of brewed coffee contains 95 to 165 milligrams of caffeine, brewed black tea contains 25 to 38 milligrams, and a bottle of Coke contains 34 milligrams of caffeine. But unlike soda, coffee, and tea, energy drinks add in guarana extract. The guarana plant, which is native to South America, produces seeds which are about the same size as a coffee bean but yield twice the caffeine content. Spread out over a day, 400 milligrams of caffeine appears to be safe, but having more than 200 milligrams in a single sitting can lead to caffeine intoxication. In 2011, it is estimated that nearly 20,000 visits to the emergency room in the United States were directly related to the effects of energy drink consumption. Most of these visits involve those between the ages of 18 to 25, and the second largest age group being 26 to 39 years old. So if you started subbing your 8 glasses of water for equivalent amounts of energy drinks, the constant increases in heart rate and blood pressure might lead to an increased risk of developing a bunch of cardiovascular conditions, including hypertension or high blood pressure. An observational study reviewed 7 years of data from calls to the Australian Poison Information Center. Of the 297 calls analyzed, the most common symptoms of caffeine toxicity included palpitations, agitation, tremor, and gastrointestinal upset. 21 cases had signs of serious cardiac or neurological toxicity, including hallucinations, seizures, arrhythmias, or cardiac ischemia, and at least 128 subjects required hospitalization. A cup of black coffee has fewer than 5 calories, but the high sugar content of energy drinks means a calorie count of about 850 calories in 8 cups of Red Bull. This increases your risk for obesity and developing type 2 diabetes. But some of the risks are unpredictable, such as a 26-year-old man who drank at least 2 cans of energy drinks daily for a decade. With no prior significant health issues, he had a seizure and fell into a 3-day coma. Doctors ultimately attributed this to chronic sleep deprivation and overconsumption of caffeine. Overall, energy drinks are relatively safe for infrequent consumption, but you may not want to drink them on a regular basis.
Hey, we want to send a huge shout out and thank you to Sarah from Domestic Geek for narrating this episode while we were away. We're going to put a link over to her channel, which is awesome. You should check it out over there.
If you don't already know, we started a podcast called Woo-hoo! Side Note. Make sure you subscribe to it wherever you get your podcasts. We tell stories, we debate, and then we splice in all the interesting information and science throughout. We've almost broken up many times because we choose subjects that we disagree on.
We disagree on a lot, though.
That's true. At the core, we are very different people.
But it's fun.
It is fun. And if you want to find out about when we almost broke up, listen to the podcast Side Note.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel.
And the podcast.
Oh, yeah.
Right? But subscribe to 2 things.
Oh, lots of things. and we will see you next Thursday for a new video. See ya.
Peace.